What's going on YouTube? Come back at you with another video. So recently we heard the news, Arab guilty, three other co-defendants guilty in this conspiracy case. Leak Moss, which is Arab's brother, not long after the sentence came down, or not the sentence, the verdict came down, he was on Instagram Live talking about the situation. Actually, if you look in the comments right there, you see Meek Mill's cousin O'Malley. He says, tell bro, I said, hold his head up. So O'Malley reacting, Leak Moss, he's also reacting. He said guilty. Some of the things that Leak Moss was talking about were actually pretty interesting. One of them, Dark Low apparently had a bail hearing recently and was denied bail. So they're going to keep Dark Low locked up until further notice. Which is kind of crazy to me that they wouldn't even give him any kind of opportunity at bail. Like, what kind of shit is that? That was interesting. He was also talking about this snitch in this case and the way that Dantes Taz Stewart was given an opportunity from the federal government to have his case, which was a murder case, converted over from a state case to a federal case, and potentially he might have the opportunity to get back released. He is facing other charges, so we don't know exactly what's going to happen with that. But as far as this murder case goes, it looks like there was some kind of plea deal worked out with the prosecution that included his testimony against Arab in this case. The feds wanted Arab bad. He was the main focus of this whole investigation. It's fucked up because it was a conspiracy case. At the end of the day, there wasn't really that much evidence at all tying Arab to these cases, or to these crimes, I should say. But because it's a conspiracy case, they don't really need much. They just need to prove that you were involved in a conspiracy or in the conspiracy. So fucked up situation for Ab. I actually saw the Philadelphia Inquisitor, I believe, they were reporting that he faces a mandatory minimum of 15 years, which is interesting because I thought it was much higher than that. So if that's actually true, and I haven't got verification on whether or not that's accurate, but if that's actually true, then it would seem to me like Arab actually has the potential of coming home someday. We'll see. He also obviously has the potential of coming home on appeal, but just dealing with the federal system as a whole, this shit is rigged. That's why they win 90%+ of their cases, because it's designed for them to win. You're not supposed to win when you fight the feds, and most people don't. So the fact that he was actually found guilty in this case, not really surprising. Although, again, it was a little surprising to me over the lack of actual corroborating evidence that connects Arab to certain things. So, crazy case. Hopefully that, you know, the judge shows some kind of leniency in this, but it was looking bad as far as the feds. They were really trying to slam Arab in this case, so I guess be ready for the worst. We'll see how this plays out in court, though. Definitely say a prayer for Arab. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. Take 1 second before you leave this video, hit the like, subscribe, share, leave some feedback. Ring the notification bell too if you're subscribed. I definitely appreciate you watching though. Peace.